What's up, everyone? So, myself, Vivek Singh, and my research paper will be on FXA and its impact on anti-aliasing. Now, before I start, let me remind you that FXA is a proprietary technique developed by NVIDIA. Now, NVIDIA is a billionaire company which has its own research division, and this was not a typical generic research paper which was written in a journal, but it was a unique thing, and it was a revolutionary thing which changed the way computing occurred in the 2004 to 2000, you can say 10, and it still is relevant. And this research paper is written by an employee of the NVIDIA Corporation. His name is Timothy Lotz. This is a very inspiring thing because FXA is something that was out of the box, that was just, you know, in a flash, a brilliant idea came and it was implemented. So let me not take much of your time, let me acquaint you with the basics of this thing. So what is anti-aliasing? The process of removing jagged pixels in a sample such as digital image is called anti-aliasing. You can see that the first image has lots of jaggedness, like there is sharp boundaries, as you can see my cursor moves here, but the second image is relatively smooth. Now, the thing here is that a line can have infinite amount of resolution, but our human eye doesn't. So, and our processing computers do not have it either. So we have to compromise. You can see the main thing here is that these pixels are not very much desirable. Something has to be done. And one thing you can say in kind of signal recording is that this can be compared to, you can say, the removal of high frequencies in a signal. So anti-aliasing can also be said that it is used to remove the high frequencies that are present, kind of like a low pass filter. Okay. And how it is applied. So essentially what happens is that at every image, at every point in our image, the edges and lines are detected. Say you have a 3D image, so this is an edge, this is a line, and this is an edge. So we did, and the algorithm detects these things. And what after that happens is that a Fourier transform is applied that decomposes this signal into different frequencies. Now here I'm just having a static image, but mind you, in a real-time 3D application such as a video game, there's a lot of moving frames per second. There's a lot of many factors. So it is actually a moving dynamic signal that is coming from the graphic card and into the rendering machine monitor, you can say. So this is like the form at every block, and the grid by grid decomposition into the Fourier transform. And this algorithm also calculates which frequencies are to be reduced above the Nyquist limit, which, if you remember in the class, is the limit at which the signal is accurately represented. We don't want all the frequencies, we want a limit. The main problem here is that this requires significant processing power. It can hog the GPU resources. Anti-aliasing is like the devil of the early computing, and it still is. You can have any image rendering, 3D processing, video games, and you apply this effect, boom, suddenly the performance dips by around 50%. It is such a significant impact on the performance of a system in anything. Anti-aliasing bogs it down. So research into this field was highly desirable. What is FXAA? Now the brilliant thing here is that this technique has extremely low latency. Like latency is like you have a graphics card. That graphics card processes the images. So that graphics card will pump the images at a variable rate. Okay, say you have a monitor refresh rate of 60 Hz, so that graphic card will actually pump that the images at variable refresh rates, and that thing. But when you apply this anti-aliasing effect, then the latency meaning the delay, the extra delay that occurs because of this additional processing required by the computer, this is significantly slow. Like 1.3 milliseconds, it is nothing. Normal anti-aliasing has a latency of like, what, like 10-20 milliseconds. That is appreciably, you can say that is appreciably disturbing the experience of an average consumer or a image renderer or a PC game player. So this FXA has logic to reduce single pixel and subpixel anti-aliasing. So this applies and the technique to every pixel, and in that pixel we have these additional grids that can be covered under the FXA. The main thing here is that it has significantly low performance cost over MSA, which is multi-sampling anti-aliasing, which was like the first anti-aliasing that came, that was like the killer of the GPUs. MSA and SMAA, super sampling anti-aliasing, TXAA, texture anti-aliasing. One thing that was a robust algorithm. So when the algorithm sees pixels that create an artificial edge, it smooths them. What happens is that the whole screen for this algorithm, the whole screen is the playground. It does not care where the edges are, where the lines are. You can see this image in the next page. The algorithm does not care where the edges and images are. It applies this filter to the whole screen, thereby creating a uniform look. Now I'll come to the pros and cons of that later, but this was revolutionary. Like, nobody thought that, hey, we can just apply this brushing effect on the whole screen and it'll be all good. Yeah. So let me give you just a brief overview of what happens here. What happens here is that we move from this right image to left image. So in the first image, you can see that the FXA takes a non-linear RGB color data, which it converts internally into a scalar estimate of luminescence for shader computation. Then it checks the local contrast to avoid processing non-edges. The local contrast at the edges, you can see this thing is having some contrast differentiation, so that is helpful, and the detected edges are in red. Here the contrast tells us that these edges have been detected, and so the pixels are processed, and when these edges are applied, and then finally the input texture is resampled given this sub-pixel offset. So this every pixel is uniformly, you can see it has been multiplied by a matrix, which creates this blur effect, this you can see blurriness. And the porting to DX9, DirectX9 and OpenGL is ridiculously simple. Like, it is not even a tough thing. And here is the tuning defines. This was another parameter, like, it allows the algorithm to process too much, like how much you want, like how much FXA do you want. This is like the sample rate, like FXA 2x, 8x, 4x, 16x. This is like this. The local contrast required to apply an algorithm, like how much the contrast difference is here. Suppose the contrast difference between these two images is very little, here and here you can see. So if I have the anti-aliasing at a lower sample, so it will essentially ignore these two things, but at higher sample it will definitely apply this whole filter on this thing. And that is it. And yeah, my suggestion are that FXA applies to the whole screen, and this can cause a lot of blurriness. That is not required. The whole screen looks foggy and as hell, so that is very much inconvenient to the casual gamers or image rendering people. And yeah, in older applications the porting is not very much smooth since the interface is relatively new, and it was not designed to remove distortions. It just removes the contrast of the image. You cannot have a sharp contrast in your image if you apply FXA on it. It literally washes out the damn thing, and it can be significantly irritating. Yeah, conclusion. FXA is the power of simple hacks and heuristics. Simple hacks. Like, anybody could have thought about that thing. Yeah, and the main thing that was inspiring about this thing is that how efficient can it be if you can find a way to tackle the problem from a different angle and think the screen not as a collection of polygons and lines, but as a collection of pixels. That for some reason sounds really philosophical to me, believe me. And I wonder if someone can make some sense of this thing. Please explain it to me. Yeah, and these were the inspirations, FXA, these all the anti-aliasing types and their research papers. Yeah, and of course the large amount of gamers. The additional sources for my images came from nvidia.com and Kotaku, PC Gaming, Quora. So that is all by my side. Thank you very much.